Hey everybody, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now this video is about 5 proven and easy tips you can implement right away for minimizing cell phone radiation. And this is actually part 2 and continued from a previous video about how research has confirmed that cell phones can cause brain cancer. And I suggest you watch that first part 1 video either right now or after you finish this one, and you can get the link to that below this video in the description area. However, as a reminder to those who did watch it, or a summary to those who haven't, I discuss how radiation from cell phones disrupts living cells and causes our DNA to become unstable, which can actually turn on and accelerate cancer genes and other chronic diseases, and in fact, more specifically, brain cancer. Again, this does not mean it's going to happen to everyone, nor am I saying you should never use a cell phone. And thus, today I'm going to give you 5 tips for reducing the radiation so you can reduce your risk and help avoid getting cancer in the future. The first is use a wired headset. Now, a wired headset will automatically decrease your radiation exposure because the phone is away from the body. Every inch you can get away, get the phone away from the body, reduces the amount of radiation you are absorbing. Now, a wired headset may still transmit radiation through the wire, but again, it's very low level. Number 2, use a speakerphone. Using the speakerphone function is helpful because, you're keeping the phone away from your brain. Every inch you can get the phone away from your body reduces the radiation, as stated earlier. In fact, holding out the cell phone by 2 inches drops the radiation by a factor of 4. That's 4 times. Now, limit Bluetooth headsets. Bluetooth wireless earpieces will expose you to some radiation, right? However, it would be much less radiation than an actual cell phone. The problem is that most people wear their Bluetooth, the headset, all the time, all day long, which means you're getting small doses of radiation all day long. So wear it only when you're using it. Also, it's a good idea to switch from one ear to the other one so you don't have too much exposure to just one side. There's something also about connecting the towers. You see, cell phones don't emit the same level of radiation. For example, your phone will emit the most radiation when it's connecting to cellular towers. For example, a moving phone, right, like kind of when you're talking while driving, will continually connect to the towers that come in and out of range. And this automatically increases the power to a maximum as the phone repeatedly attempts to connect to from one antenna to the next. Now, a weak signal, on the other hand, will also cause your phone to work harder trying to connect all the time and give off more radiation. So if you can, try avoiding using your phone in elevators and other kind of low reception areas where your phone has to work a lot harder. Research shows that your device emits more radiation when transmitting also than when receiving. And finally, text more and talk less. All right, try texting more and talking less because it'll keep the phone away from your face, which will reduce the radiation going to your brain. And I think a lot more people are texting these days. Simply stated, do your best to keep your phone at a distance, especially when you're not using it. And I said in my previous video, this is especially true at night while sleeping. So many people just put the phone right by their head while sleeping at night. Again, it's not good for your health and especially not good for your sleep. At the very least, put it on airplane mode. All right, that's it for today. I hope you found this helpful. And if you did, please share it with a friend. And if you're not already subscribed, please do me a favor and do so right now. And then click that bell icon so you'll be notified when future videos are available. And also do me a big favor and let me know what topics you'd like me to cover in my videos. I have a special link below in the description area that you can fill out and it'll go directly to my private email box. This helps me make videos that you want to watch about topics that you're interested in. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.